Welcome to Free Education. We will discuss some important questions from environmental science, pollutants and ecosystems. These topics are very much important from all the exams point of views for NTA, UGC, NET, past papers, both past paper and second paper, and FSSAi exam. Many exams are nowadays including environmental science either in first paper or in second paper. So let's start. First question is, all are primary pollutants except peroxyacyl nitrate. Peroxyacyl nitrate is not primary pollutants, it is secondary pollutants. Ammonia, sulfur dioxide, hydrogen sulfide, these are primary pollutants. Okay, so peroxyacyl nitrate is a secondary pollutants. Next question. Pollutants that are introduced into the environment by human activity are called as qualitative pollutants. Okay, so pollutants that are introduced into the environment by human activity are called qualitative pollutants. Next, air pollution is severe in which area? Air pollution is severe in cities, industrialized areas, densely populated areas. So all of the above are severely polluted regions, where air is polluted a lot. Particulate pollutants are small solid particles and liquid droplets. So particulate pollutants are small solid particles and liquid droplets. Next, all are particulate pollutants except ozone. Ozone is not a particulate pollutants. Dust, soot, smokes, all are particulate pollutants. So ozone is not a particulate pollutants. Next, fine organic or inorganic particles suspended in air is called aerosol. Fine organic or inorganic particles suspended in air is called aerosol. Which of the following is a secondary pollutants? Carbon dioxide is primary pollutants. Carbon monoxide is also a primary pollutants. O3, ozone is a secondary pollutant. So O3 is the right answer. Next question. Air pollution can be of natural origin, artificial or man-made origin. Both are correct. So C is the right answer. So air pollution can be natural and man-made origin. Next, mobile combustion accounts what? How much percentage it accounts? It accounts 50 to 60% of air pollution. So mobile combustion accounts 50 to 60% of air pollution. Next, the true statement about greenhouse effect is that it is caused only by carbon dioxide, CFC, CH4 and nitrogen dioxide gases. Next, the supersonic jets cause pollution by the thinning of what? By thinning of O3 layer. The supersonic jet cause pollution by thinning of ozone layer or O3 layer. Next, carbon monoxide is a pollutant because it reacts with hemoglobin present in our blood. carbon monoxide is a pollutant because it reacts with hemoglobin. Next, a population is a group of what? A group of individuals in a species. A population is a group of individual in a species. Next, what is the most important factor for the success of animal population? Adaptability. Without adaptability, there is no success in animal population. So adaptability is required for the success of animal population. Next, the formula for exponential population growth is what? For exponential population growth, we have dn by dt is equal to rn is the formula. Next, human population growth curve is a J-shaped curve. J-shaped curve. It will be like this. Human population growth curve is a J-shaped curve. Next, exponential growth occurs when there is no environmental resistance. When there is no environmental resistance, automatically the growth will be on exponential basis. Okay, next question. A human population is small, there is a great chance of genetic drift. If human population is very small, then a chance is there that genetic drift will happen. Regarding genetic drift, we can understand that in another lectures. Next, in a population, unrestricted reproductive capacity is called as what? In a population, unrestricted reproductive capacity is called birth rate. Okay. Next, the concept that population tends to increase geometrically while food supply increases arithmetically was put forward by Thomas Malthus. Thomas Malthus given that idea about population tends to increase geometrically while food supply increases arithmetically. Next, two opposite forces operate in the growth and development of every population. One of them is related to the ability to reproduce at a given rate. The force opposite to it is called mortality rate. So two opposite forces are there. One of them is related to the ability to reproduce and another is mortality rate. Next, the carrying capacity of a population is determined by its what? The carrying capacity of the population is determined by its limiting resources. What are the resources that limiting that population? Next, the major pollutants from automobile exhaust is carbon monoxide. Because carbon dioxide is produced, because we are using carbon based petroleum or hydrocarbon based diesel, all these things, that's why our waste is mainly carbon oxide, carbon dioxide, but here carbon monoxide is the right answer. Next, the greenhouse gases, otherwise called radioactively active gases, includes what? Carbon dioxide, correct, CH4 also, nitrogen oxide also. So all of these are the part of greenhouse gases. Okay, and they are radioactively active gases. Okay, next, algal blooms results in eutrophication. Eutrophication mein kya hota hai? Algal bloom develop hota hai. Next, a high biological oxygen demand indicates that
अगर BOD ज़्यादा होता है तो इट क्या, ये क्या इंडिकेट करता है, हाई लेवल ऑफ माइक्रोबियल पोल्यूशन इज देयर, दैट्स व्हाई देयर इज हाई लेवल ऑफ BOD. नेक्स्ट, द इफेक्ट ऑफ रेडियोएक्टिव पोल्यूटेंट्स डिपेंड्स अपॉन व्हाट, रेट ऑफ डिफ्यूजन करेक्ट, एनर्जी रिलीजिंग कैपेसिटी इज ऑल्सो करेक्ट, rate of deposition of contaminant is also there. So all of this is the right answer. The effects of radioactive pollutants depend on what?
Rate of diffusion, energy releasing capacity, rate of deposition of the contaminants. Next. So all of this is correct. Next. The range of normal human hearing is the range of what? 50 hertz to 15,000 hertz. Next, the pollution which does not persistent harm to life supporting system is noise pollution. All of the rest cause what? It can damage life, but this noise pollution is not persistent harm to life supporting system. Okay, next, soap and detergents are the source of organic pollutants like glycerol, polyphosphates, sulfonated hydrocarbons. So all of these are what? Sources of organic pollutants sources are glycerol, polyphosphates, sulfonated hydrocarbons. Next, growing agricultural crops between rows of planted trees is known as tongia system. Growing agricultural crops between rows of planted trees is known as tongia system. The main atmospheric layer near the surface of earth is troposphere. Troposphere is the main atmospheric layer near the earth's surface. Next, man-made sources of radiation pollution are mining, okay, explosion of nuclear weapon is also there, nuclear fuels and preparation of radioactive isotopes, all of these are man-made sources of radiation pollution. All of this, mining, explosion of nuclear weapons, nuclear fuels and preparation of radioactive isotopes, all of this. Next, the cutting down of trees and setting them on fire and raising crops on the resulting ash is called zoom. Next, percentage of forest area recommended by the National Forest Policy for plants is 33%. Minimum 33% should be there as a forest area which is recommended by National Forest Policy. Next, example of primary pollutants are what? Hydrocarbons are examples of primary pollutants. Next, commonly used radioactive isotopes in scientific research is 14 carbon is also used, 1251 I is also used, 32 P is also used. So all of these are used as a research material, okay, for what? Isotopes in scientific research. So 14 carbon, 125 iodine and 32 phosphorus is used. Next, drinking of fluoride containing water results in fluorosis. Drinking of fluoride containing water results in fluorosis. Chipko movement is a public agitation that occurred in which area? It was happened in Tehri Garhwal area of Uttar Pradesh. Next, high biological oxygen demand indicates what? Intense level of microbial pollution is there. Intense level of microbial pollution is there if high biological oxygen demand is present. Then ozonosphere seen in where? Stratosphere. It is found in stratosphere. Next, harmful trace metals in fly ash. What are the harmful trace metals? These are antimony, then cadmium, then arsenic. All of these are the harmful trace metals in fly ash. Next, in a pyramid of numbers in a grassland ecosystem, the largest population is that of producers. Producers are the largest in pyramid of numbers for a grassland ecosystem. Which of the following group of gases cause photochemical smog? So oxygen, PAN and nitrogen dioxide, all these are group of gases which cause photochemical smog. Which of the following statements regarding species interdependence are true? So the right statements are: a direct food relation between two species of animals in which one animal kills and feed on another is referred as predation, and a relationship between two species of organisms where both the partners are benefited from each other is called symbiosis. These two sentences are correct. C and D are correct. Next, the species of plants that play a vital role in controlling the relative abundance of other species in a community are called keystone species. These are called keystone species, which help in the species of plants that play a vital role in controlling the relative abundance of other species in a community are called keystone species. Habitat loss and fragmentation, over exploitation, alien species invasion and co-extinctions are causes for biodiversity loss. So what are those? Habitat loss and fragmentation, over exploitation, alien species invasion and co-extinctions are causing what? Biodiversity loss. Next, the formula of growth rate for population in given time is dN by dt is equal to rn. Then next, one greenhouse gas contributes 14% of total global warming and another contributes 6%. These are respectively identified as CFC and N2O. Which of the following is false? The energy content in a trophic level is determined by considering a few individuals of species in that trophic level is false. Next, all are correct. Quantity of biomass in a trophic level at a particular period is called a standing crop, correct. The succession that occurs in newly cooled lava is called primary succession, correct. Rate of succession is faster in secondary succession is also correct. Phytoplanktons are the pioneers in the aquatic ecosystems is also correct. Next, many freshwater animals cannot live for long in sea water and vice versa, mainly because of the osmotic problems. Okay, freshwater animals cannot live in ocean and vice versa because of osmotic problems. Okay, So our last question is, which of the following regarding ecological pyramid is not correct? See, in ecological pyramids, we have both kinds of pyramids. One is inverted pyramid, another one is upright pyramid. So we cannot say here that in most of ecosystems, the pyramid of numbers and biomass are upright. We cannot say like that. So this statement is not a correct statement regarding ecological pyramids. Okay, we cannot say like that.
We have finished this lesson. If you have any doubt, any question, please put in the comment section. Thank you a lot. Have a nice day.